Backups are very important, and we do take backups every day. But it may happen that the backup taken gets corrupted, or maybe the backup we are about to restore is an obsolete one. So the question arises, how do we know if the backup file is appropriate and without any corruption? Well, in this tutorial, we will look into how we can validate these backup files. The validating process is a simple process that checks whether the backup file has any corruptions in it. It checks if the data in the backup is in sync with the database. You could even carry out a demo restoration to check for any errors. This minimizes the possibility of problems that an inappropriate backup restoration could create. So let's go through the steps to validate a backup file. The tool that we would be working with is the DBRestore tool, which acts in two ways. One, it restores your backup. Two, it tests your backup files. Run the DBRestore tool. Now you would see two sets of connection details mentioned, one for the local database and the other for the web database. The connection details displayed are retrieved from the GINApps file, which contains all the connection details. Test both the connections and click Next. We click the Locate button to locate the backup file and select the file that has to be validated. Below that, we see three tabs: the Backup Snapshot, Full Backup Info, and the Differential Backup Info. The Backup Snapshot Info provides the necessary information related to the backup file. There are a few aspects we have to check out here. The proper store name with a proper COID should be displayed. The last DXN ID and the last DX receipt ID in the backup file and in the web database must match. In case any of the data is not proper, the DBRestore tool will not restore the backup. The full backup info and the differential backup info provides the technical information about the backup data. Let's move on to the restore path section. We create a test database out here. Give a name other than your POS database. Let's say npos test db1 and click restore. If the restore is successful, the npos test db1 database is created and this validates the backup data. Please note that the test database must not be attached to the software. It is recommended to remove it after you test the backup data. So that's how a backup data is validated. It is recommended that as soon as the backup is taken, the backup data should be validated. This helps in a smooth data restore. Subscribe to GINESYS to know more. Thank you.